Bannon accuses Trump campaign of treasonous meeting with Russians. Internet wants answers. Trump's former chief strategist Steve Bannon decried Don Jr.'s meeting with Russians as treasonous and bad SHT. Read the shocking interview here. Update: President Donald Trump has responded to Steve Bannon's interview in fire and fury, inside the Trump White House, with the following statement: "Steve Bannon has nothing to do with me or my presidency." When he was fired, he not only lost his job, he lost his mind. "Steve was a staffer who worked for me after I had already won the nomination by defeating 17 candidates, often described as the most talented field ever assembled in the Republican Party. Now that he is on his own, Steve is learning that winning isn't as easy as I make it look. Steve had very little to do with our historic victory, which was delivered by the forgotten men and women of this country. Yet Steve had everything to do with the loss of a Senate seat in Alabama held for more than 30 years by Republicans. Steve doesn't represent my base. He's only in it for himself. Steve pretends to be at war with the media, which he calls the opposition party, yet he spent his time at the White House leaking false information to the media to make himself seem far more important than he was. It is the only thing he does well. Steve was rarely in a one-on-one meeting with me and only pretends to have had influence to fool a few people with no access and no clue, whom he helped write phony books. We have many great Republican members of Congress and candidates who are very supportive of the Make America Great Again agenda. Like me, they love the United States of America and are helping to finally take our country back and build it up, rather than simply seeking to burn it all down." Former White House chief strategist Steve Bannon told author Mike Wolff in his new book of interviews, Fire and Fury, inside the Trump White House, that he believes Donald Trump Jr., Paul Manafort, and Jared Kushner's meeting with Russians at Trump Tower during the 2016 election season was unpatriotic, and allegedly treason. Bannon suggests that the so-called treason isn't the problem, as many on Twitter have pointed out, but the fact that the senior presidential campaign officials didn't go about their meeting in the right way. He's quoted in the book as saying that he believes now that they're going to crack Don Jr. like an egg on national TV. "The three senior guys in the campaign thought it was a good idea to meet with a foreign government inside Trump Tower in the conference room on the 25th floor, with no lawyers. They didn't have any lawyers," Bannon is quoted as saying in Fire and Fury, obtained by The Guardian. "Even if you thought that this was not treasonous, or unpatriotic, or bad SHT, and I happen to think it's all of that, you should have called the FBI immediately." The meeting in question happened in July 2016, as revealed by The New York Times, during which Trump Jr., Manafort, and Kushner met with Russian lawyer Natalia Veselnitskaya at Trump Tower over what Trump Jr. initially said was information about Russian U.S. adoption. NIT revealed through obtained emails that the campaign officials were promised documents that could incriminate Donald Trump's Democratic opponent Hillary Clinton. Instead of reporting the message to the FBI, Trump Jr. replied in an email, "I love it." Trump Jr. said no such material was produced at the meeting and maintains his innocence. Bannon also criticized Trump's decision to fire FBI Director James Comey, and further expressed desire to end Special Counsel Robert Mueller's investigation into Russian collusion. "The FBI's path to F King Trump goes right through Paul Manafort, Don Jr. and Jared Kushner. It's as plain as a hair on your face," he's quoted as saying in the book, which features interviews from 200 people connected to the Trump White House. Needless to say, voters on Twitter are disturbed by the Fire and Fury excerpt, "Dear Steve Bannon, please give Mueller something really juicy and we all promise to stop photoshopping extra sores on your face." Randy Mayensinger, at Ramayensinger, January 3, 2018. Bannon says Trump campaign committed treason. Thomas Barrick says Trump is not only crazy, he's stupid. Tillerson says Trump is a fucking moron. With friends like these. Rob Reiner, at Robriner, January 3, 2018. Pretty amazing that Trump managed to replace a campaign advisor who can't keep his hands off women with a campaign advisor now under house arrest with a campaign advisor now accusing his kids of treason. Kilgore Trout, at KT underscore so underscore it underscore goes, January 3, 2018. Sorry, Donald Trump Jr., you have to be better at treason to stay on Steve Bannon and number 39 semicolon s good side. Randy Mayumsinger, at Ramayumsinger, January 3, 2018. If I finally tell the truth about at real Donald Trump his money laundering and treason, will you remove this rat from my cheek? Steve Bannon who signed on knowing it all. pic.twitter.com/2j1w23z, Richard Nixon Zombie, at Renixon Zombie, January 3, 2018. Steve Bannon. After your crowned pedophile got his ass kicked, you had a weeks-long binge on liquor and orphan tears. Woke with a hangover, causing even someone as despicable as you to utter a fundamental truth. Treason flows through the veins of Trump and number 39 semicolon s incompetent demon spawn. Aiden Wolf, at Aiden Wolf, January 3, 2018. Trump had three campaign managers. 1. Corey Lewandowski, accused of sexual assault. 2. Paul Manafort, indicted for money laundering and conspiracy. 3. Steve Bannon, accused top campaign aides of treason, presists, at Forever Never Trump. January 3, 2018. Hollywood lifers, are you shocked that Bannon called the meeting treasonous after supporting Trump? Let us know.